Just because you can sell somebody doesn't mean you should sell somebody. This is a conversation I've been having with quite a few of my colleagues lately who are all very good at selling. We all know how to sell. We've sold from the platform, we've sold on webinars, we've sold at summits. And what we have come to the conclusion of is some people shouldn't be sold, period. Now, I know the old adage is people want to buy, they don't want to be sold, but the reality is we're in business to make money. How we make money is we sell something, whether it be a product or a service. When it comes to high-priced services, many of us went through very extensive training to learn how to do this and do it well. To the tune of making hundreds of thousands of dollars during 2 and 3 day events. And the conclusion that many of us came to is we were really good, we are really good at selling. And yet there's some people that shouldn't buy our services, period, end of story. Let me give you an example. I happen to be involved in training for a sprint triathlon. Now, that's not a full triathlon. That's a baby triathlon. It's a 5K run, it's a quarter mile swim, and it's a 12 mile bike ride. As I've been training, there's certain equipment that I definitely need in order to train effectively. I have fins for my hands. They're actually like flippers for my hands because it builds up upper body strength. I have fins for my feet. Doesn't mean I can use it during the actual triathlon. However, it helps with my training. One thing I don't need is a tank for oxygen to do deep sea diving. Has nothing to do with a triathlon. And if somebody came to me and really pushed and pushed to try to sell me and used every argument there was to convince me that that's what I needed, and they knew deep in their heart that I didn't need it, that's selling with lack of integrity. So the whole point of the conversations that I've been having with people is you definitely want to sell people who you know your products and services can help. You definitely don't want to sell, if you want to stay in integrity, to those people who are not a good fit. They've made it really clear they're not going to do the work. And no matter what you do, you're not going to be that one magical person that convinces them they need to do the work. If somebody doesn't do the work, they don't do the work. Here's another really good example. A few years ago, I had a client that I asked her, you know, how's it been with your other coaches and with other consultants you've worked with? And she made it very clear that in the beginning, everything always goes great. Things are wonderful, but every single relationship went south, every single one. And she convinced me that I would be different. Well, in my heart of hearts, I knew I wasn't going to be different. And yet I decided to go ahead and work with her. Sure enough, the first few months, everything was wonderful. Things were humming along. And then all of a sudden, she quit doing the work. All of a sudden, she started getting really nitpicky about things that before she wasn't nitpicky about. As a matter of fact, before she said everything was great. And all of a sudden, things went south. Well, the reality is, it wasn't all of a sudden. The reality is, I never should have signed her. But sometimes we let the almighty dollar rule our logic and our heart. The reality is there are people that you should not work with. There are people that are not a good fit for your services. And just because you can sell something doesn't mean you should sell something. This is Kathleen Gage with Power Up for Profits, encouraging you to look at the way that you sell, look at the level of integrity that you have with yourself. It doesn't mean that you're not an integrous person. It just means sometimes you might compromise. And really ask yourself, is this what I'm supposed to be doing? Is this the next step of where I need to be going in my business? Because again, not everybody needs to work with you, and you don't need to work with everybody. This is Kathleen Gage wishing you a great day.